Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I am going to show you how to bind data to the Vue Gantt Chart component. I can bind three types of data to a Gantt Chart: hierarchical data, self-referential data, and remote data. I will show you how to bind each of them. First, I open my existing Vue project, where all the necessary Gantt Chart modules are configured. I have added the data.js file, which has hierarchical local JSON data with task and subtask details. For the first object, I have added the fields task ID, task name, and so on with appropriate values. You can also see the child object with the same fields. Now, I import this project new data from the data.js file. In the data method, assign this object to the variable data and assign this variable to the data source property. Next, I must map the necessary data source fields to find the project task values using the task fields property. To do that, I declare a variable task fields and map data source fields to the task values such as task ID, task name, start date, end date, duration, and progress. I also map the subtasks field from the data source to the child property. Finally, I assign this variable to the task fields property. Also, I set the custom height to the component. And set the tree column index to 1. To have an expand button in the name column. Next, I added the column customization using the columns and column directive. To learn more about configuring Vue Gantt Chart, you can refer to my Getting Started video, the link for which I've shared in the card above and the description below. Let me run this application using the command npm run serve. See here, the left pane has a tree grid, and the right pane has a chart with a project timeline. Now, let's see how to bind self-referential data, that is, flat data. The data.js file contains self-referential data, and it has a data structure that contains the ID and parent ID mapping fields. Notice here the task ID field contains unique values used to identify each task and it should be mapped to the ID property. The parent ID field contains values that indicate parent tasks, and it should be mapped to the parent ID property of the Gantt chart. In this case, task 1 is the parent node for task 2. In addition to these two fields, I have added the usual task values, task name, start date, end date, duration, and progress. In the app.vue file, import that self data from the data.js file and change the data source property value to load this flat data. In the task field settings, most of the data source fields mapped are identical to the self-data object fields. I'll change the casing alone. In addition to these fields, I need to map the parent ID field. With this method of flat data binding, we don't need to set the child property, so I will comment it out. At last, I add the dependency property in the task field settings to display task dependency in the timeline and map the predecessor field from the data source. Also change the casing of the field property values in the eColumn tags. As you can see, the Gantt chart renders with the self-referential data. Now, if you are wondering how to bind remote data to a Gantt chart, you can access an online data service with the help of the Data Manager. The Data Manager is a Syncfusion library that acts as a gateway and interacts with both local and remote data sources. In this example, I'm going to use the Web API adapter to bind data. First, I import the Data Manager and Web API adapter from the Syncfusion EJ2 data package. I'll comment out the code that imports the local data from the file data.js. In the data method, I initialize the data manager for the variable data. To interact with a remote data service, the data manager requires a URL and adapter. I will provide the valid service URL to fetch the remote data. This is the online service that I'm going to use in my application. Next, I need to specify the adapter type. The adapter is responsible for processing the response from the service endpoint and the request to it. This service URL is created based on Web API standards. So, I set the adapter to Web API adapter. Then, I enable the cross-domain property. In the task field settings, the map data source fields are mostly the same as the fields in the remote data object. I will only modify the casing. Since it is hierarchical data, I comment out the parent ID mapping and map the subtasks field from the remote data source to the child property. Also change the casing of the field property values in the eColumn tags. Looking here, the Gantt chart renders with the remote data. In this video, I have shown you how to bind hierarchical, self-referential, and remote data to the Gantt chart component. You can download a working example from the GitHub link in the description for this video below. You can also see if you're eligible for our community license, which will get you a free license key to use our products. If you found this video useful, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel. Thank you for watching.